Hey, welcome back. And this morning, let's draw something different. And I know I've been drawing a lot of portraits and other stuff. Let's try some flowers. I got some images of these flowers. Maybe I'll just do some quick sketches with these flowers with the number two pencil. And just kind of go over it, maybe kind of be a little bit more loose, a little bit more sketchy. So let's see where that goes. All right, so I generally don't draw this kind of stuff, but I mean, you know, art is kind of the same way we draw everything. Let's see. All right, let's say, I believe this is a rose. I don't know too much about flowers. So I'm just going to draw a kind of like a rough shape. This is kind of be the size, roughly. And then let's just go from there. And hope you guys can see, this is kind of light. So I'm just kind of sketching. This petal, like this one right in the middle right here, and I'll go from there. This one comes here, and then here's a big one on the bottom. So I'm just looking at the big shapes. Big one here, here's one. It's got that, and then the inside here, another clump, more petals, and then the outside just around. Then let's see, out here, here, bump here, petal, petal, and see this big one over here. Now I can divide it up now that I have, you know, more of the major shapes in. Now I'll draw in the little details here. So it's here and here. And of course, this is one, this is a major shape and this is a smaller shape. And then within here, there's actually a little, you know, wavy line kind of going all the way across. But we don't draw that yet because we want to fill in everything else first. So we're just kind of going from big to small. And if you want to sketch and stay loose, and that's kind of how you have to do it. You know, you don't want to draw in the details now. All right, so now that I have these shapes, let's start a center here. So I'm just going to draw in some of these lines here. It's very roughly. So now I'll cut in and draw in more of the smaller details. This curve here. So there is a lot of curves, not too many major lines other than this right here. On the petal, it is actually very wavy. And the shading part of this might be kind of fun. That's kind of what made me want to draw something like this. So when you're sketching, you notice that how I go over the lines multiple times, because it's a lot easier to do this as opposed to just trying to draw a clean line. And with sketching, you really don't want that clean of a line anyways. You want to kind of keep everything moving. So like that, then I cut in bigger shapes and then I can draw in slightly cleaner line. And what happens in general when you're drawing, if you draw this kind of shape, just say like an S shape, if you keep doing it, your arm actually memorizes that that motion. So you can repeat this kind of motion and you get a kind of a decent line out of any kind of curvature. If you just keep repeating it, you notice that you can actually keep running. It's kind of strange. It's like a motor. And you know, that's why when you're sketching, you just kind of want to keep everything moving. And when it is a correct line, what happens when you're doing this, your hand will automatically just kind of push in more, and then that's how you get those darker lines. Okay, so you get a nice little gradation, very smooth, very fluid, as opposed to a line like this, you're getting a very smooth line. Okay, so let's see, let's get back to this. Okay, so how's that? All right, I think that's close enough. Let's start to shade, and this one's a little bit interesting because the red part it's going to be much darker than the white. So I'm going to try to recreate that. So all the red parts right here, just going to give it a shade first, because this is going to be a lot darker. And by doing this, you know, I'll be able to hopefully make this, the lighter part actually look like it's white. Yeah, just by sheer contrast. Okay, so the direction of the strokes, I always like to go, like if it's vertical like this, I mean going this direction, I always like to go this way as opposed to going that way, because this way is a lot harder because it's longer strokes. So I always kind of cut in. So like this, I'll just keep turning. Actually, this is really light. Maybe a 2B is not a good idea. I mean, an HB is not a good idea. All right, so let's go from here. I don't want to draw the whole thing first. So let's just take this petal. This one is red. And then on the edge right here, as it rolls away, it gets a little bit darker. So let's just hit that a little bit more. And then on this edge, it's slightly darker too. Just slightly. Let's try that. Then let's see here. This part's kind of cool. So this edge is important because when I make this dark, this thing's gonna pop right out. So there's some variations right here. It's a little bit of a curve right there. A little bit of crease. Okay, so let's concentrate in here. So right here, just a little bit of shading right here. Actually more, a little bit more pinkish, and then this part slightly darker. And then on this side here, this one's darker as well. This is turning away from the light. Light source is right here. And then on the bottom right here as well, because this is kind of round, it's like a ball. Okay, so now we got that. So now let's draw in. Let's draw in this petal then. So I'm not gonna draw in the water droplets. So this edge is gonna roll away, so it's darker. And then within here, there's some variation too. This is slightly darker here. And then the bottom right here is dark. Let's come to this one. If you look at this smaller petal here, it's slightly darker than this. So I'm just gonna make this a little bit darker. And then we get the same thing here, it's rolling away. It's gonna be darker. Okay, and then right here, this one's cool. Again, this needs to be dark or else this thing won't show up. So you're looking at the petal, this petal right here and this one, it's almost the same value in terms of the red. Same darkness. This right here is the shadow. And then right here, it rolls away again. So this one's dark. But this part is light because it's catching a light here. And then if you look here, this is how you can make the rose kind of come alive. Between here, this edge needs to be a lot lighter. I guess I didn't catch that. But I'll just erase this. Then right here, should be a little bit darker. Okay, and that will help to pop this edge out. So that's really how a rose is, because it's folding, you know, on top of each other. You're gonna get a lot of these illusions right here. And if we exaggerate them, it will help, you know, make the flower a little bit more three-dimensional. Like here, if we make it a little bit darker, you know, just really pops things out. Okay, so up here, this part darker. Yeah, this is a lot more shading. Maybe I drawn it a little bit too big. Especially with a number two, it's just so thin. Okay, so this edge right here. Okay, let's keep going. Let's see right here, this edge. Again, right here, I'm going to exaggerate it a little bit, make it a little bit darker. I mean, it is dark in the reference, but you can always exaggerate it. This edge here, I'm just going to simplify this because it's a smaller detail. I don't want to draw too much of this because everything else is kind of rough. So I want to try to keep things a little bit more consistent in terms of the detail level. So right here, gonna be darker, and that's gonna help pop out what's inside here. Okay, here, another petal here. Darker here, it's going to help pop up this edge. Do some other petals in here as well. Okay, so let's see how that looks. Oh, I see the shapes, but it's looking kind of dead. Gonna come around, see it here. Yeah, this flower doesn't have a lot of life. Mainly because if you look at this kind of stuff, it looks very robotic. And that is probably my strokes are very angular. It's feeling a little bit more like a comic book style. Yeah, I think if I use a softer pencil, it might be a little bit better. But, you know, with this, if I go in there and just shade in more stuff, you know, it should look okay. Just adding more detail, you know, crosshatch, get rid of some of the angular lines. See, that feels a little bit better right here already. So I guess when I'm dividing these edges up, you know, because the lines are so straight, it just looks, yeah, very robotic. Just kind of have to come in here and just kind of mess things up a little bit more. Okay, I won't draw more of this. This is okay. I'll switch to the another pencil after this one. Yeah, I might sketch some more. I think this one it's okay. It's done. I'll add in more details later. Let's go on to the next one. Let's use, what is this? All right, let's use a 6B then. For this one, let's see, let's draw this one. I'm not sure what flower this is. Let's draw that. That's kind of cool. All right, so I'm just gonna draw here. And all right, so this one, when you look at it, it's basically like a triangular shape. Let's say here's the middle. Here's one petal. And then here's another one, so I'm just gonna just sketch it like this. It doesn't necessarily have to be exactly the same, obviously. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. And then in between, there's one more. So these ones are gonna be behind, underneath. Okay, and the flower is all, you know, there's a lot of soft focusing right here, but we'll just draw it sharp. Okay, so let's see, let's start in here. I don't know what's in here. It looks like, I don't know much about flowers. My wife plants a lot of stuff in the garden. All I know is this gives me a lot of allergies, so I'm not really into them. Okay, so here is the inside here. I don't know what those three things are. Yeah, this is much better, 6B. So soft. Okay, so let's draw this petal right here. I think this one's kind of interesting. Just gonna outline it slightly more. And then on in here, center, and then let's start shading. So it's dark on the tip here. And it gets lighter and lighter. I don't know if that's just the lighting or the flower itself. It could be, yeah, it looks like it's whiter on the inside here. So right here, this is the highlight. And then when it turns in, this is slightly darker. It's very subtle. So you get this curve right here. And then this edge right here is really dark. And then for these textures, you can actually come in here and draw in some of these lines. Just ever so slightly. Okay, so that's one. Let's draw this one. Yeah, maybe I should sharpen up this pencil. But it's okay. You know, soft, nice and soft. It's okay if it's not too sharp. Okay, so right here, the white's right here, this part's darker. It's darkest right here, this actually curves in, so this is a little tricky. Turn my pencil, get a harder edge, get that line. So now that I shaded this, the inside here looks a little bit too light. I'm just gonna come in here and just punch that in. Okay, so that's two, and let's draw this one. This one's kind of cool because it's in the shadow here. So right here, this shadow, this is very important. Darker here. And here's another shadow from this petal. And the highlight is just really here. So everything else needs to have a little bit of shading. It's darker here. Yeah, what's that? I know that part's really blurry. But I think we can still kind of see what we need to shade. Here, dark. A little bit of highlight here. This part's darker. Highlights here. Okay, let's draw this one. Darker here. The highlight is right here and here. This is important right here, the shadow. This will help separate out the petals. Wait, my throat is getting coarse. I'm just squinting my eyes to see the major shading here. Okay, so one more up here. The lights here, this part slightly darker. I'm doing these little wiggly shapes. Okay, let's see. So when I first started, I started here and my pencil was, I guess, slightly sharper. And then as I started drawing the other ones, my pencil was duller, but also was a little bit looser, and you can kind of see the difference, right? This is a lot more softer, and this is a little, this looks a little dead. So in terms of life and just liveliness, you know, this to me feels much better than this. But I can always kind of go in and, you know, mess things up a little bit. Just kind of go over the whole flower, you know, don't work in the whole, not on each individual petal, but just kind of keep moving around. And that will help to make things a little bit more consistent throughout. Okay. All right, so I think that is it for this flower. If I had to add any more detail, I'll just sharpen up the pencil, and I'll probably do that. When I turn the cameras off, I'll just kind of finish off the drawing, adding a little bit more detail. Hopefully I can push it up into another level. And I was gonna draw one more flower, but then my voice is really coarse, so I think two is enough for this video. Yeah, so let me know if you guys, any other subject that you want me to draw, or, you know, even if it's a certain type of flowers, just let me know, you know, in the comments. And if it's something cool, I can definitely draw it. I mean, even if it's not cool, I'll probably still draw it. It's nice to draw different things. All right, so I hope you guys enjoy this flower drawings, and I will see you guys next time.